And when children become victims, other children can't always comprehend it.
One expert says in New Orleans, it's not only the national news stories, but crime here as well. WGNO's Kenny Lopez has some tips and resources for parents. Kenny.
You know, Kurt and Susie, health experts say when something as horrible as this happens, many parents are not sure exactly how to confront it with their kids. But the most important thing to do is not avoid it and give your child the space they need to let all their feelings out.
But what makes me really stressed is that people hurt other people. That makes me really angry.
Anger, fear, confusion, depression. These are all emotions a child might feel after hearing about other children being killed in Uvalde.
Dying from unnecessary things.
Talking about those emotions is extremely important for kids to get the stress off their chests.
I think talking about it not only helps to heal, but allows children to know that it's okay to be vulnerable. It's okay to say that this really scared me.
Dr. Julie Kaplow, the executive director of the Trauma and Grief Center at Children's Hospital New Orleans, advises parents to let the kids guide the conversations.
So sometimes as adults, we have a tendency to provide more information than they need, which can be overwhelming. Even saying things like, I know you must have heard about what happened in Texas. What questions do you have for me? Or what things are worrying you? Can really allow for the child to be more empowered to guide that conversation.
When a child is feeling grief or trauma, there are signals.
So for younger children, that can look like excessive clinginess, not wanting to separate from their caregiver.
Dr. Kaplow says New Orleans families can relate to the tragedy at Robb Elementary School because of all the gun violence here.
Can just add to that cumulative effect of being exposed to those kinds of traumas over and over.
People are getting shot every day, and that can cause you to be depressed.
It can really help children when parents can sort of reestablish that sense of safety and security.
Dr. Kaplow also says it goes beyond the home, and educators can help by not avoiding talking about it at school. She says kids know what's going on, and by acting like it's taboo, it could make matters worse for kids. We'll have a link on our website with the phone number to the Trauma and Grief Center at Children's Hospital. Kurt?
All right, great tips. Thank you, Kenny.